Hello and welcome to South Asia Today, a show that provides you the glimpses of South Asia. I'm your host Shreya Savijay. Here are the headlines. Chinese delegation visits Kathmandu amid deepening political crisis. Soaring wheat flour prices sparks protest in POK. Police attack, arrest demonstrators. And Indian classical dancers reign at international festival. Let's begin the show. The political crisis in Nepal is not appearing to be dying down. In fact, it has deepened with sweeping protests across the capital and other parts of the country, demanding the rollback of the dissolution of the lower house of the parliament. Meanwhile, the country's neighbour China, which has been accused in past of being intrusive, is reaching out to the communist leaders of Nepal. The self-assumed mediator is reportedly trying to bring all stakeholders on negotiating table to prevent chaos and instability. But can China be trusted? There are many who believe that Beijing has ulterior motives and will never help Nepal without its strategic and trade interests.
Tens of thousands of Nepalese who have been opposing Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli's haste move to dissolve parliament took to the streets of Kathmandu, demanding a withdrawal of the move. They termed the move immoral and unconstitutional. Oli had prematurely dissolved the parliament despite having a majority in the House. Protesters say the constitution of Nepal that was promulgated in 2015 doesn't allow such exercise. The government must complete its 5 years. They also said that such decisions would not only set a wrong precedent but would also hamper the political stability of the Himalayan country.
प्रधानमन्त्री दुई जना एकलले चाहिँ यो जुन संसद विघटन गरेकोमा नेपाली जनता आक्रोशित पनि छन् र यो 5 वर्षको म्यान्डेट दिएका नेपाली जनताले 5 वर्षको म्यान्डेटमा गर्दछ संविधान विपरीत यो विघटन गरेकोमा आम नेपाली जनता यसको विरुद्धमा छन्।
Oli had taken the calculative move to prevent his ouster from the government, where he was witnessing an increasing opposition within his own party, as many of the cabinet members had joined the Dahal faction to present a no-confidence motion against him. Oli has thus far defended his decision, saying the internal squabbling and a lack of cooperation from his party has paralyzed decision-making, forcing him to seek a fresh popular mandate. Meanwhile, Beijing, which has self-assumed the role of a mentor in Nepal politics, dispatched a 4-member team to Kathmandu. Led by Guo Jiazhou, a vice minister of the International Department of the Chinese Communist Party, who had played a key role in the merger of the communist parties in Nepal post-2017 elections, the delegation met almost all major stakeholders behind closed doors. Beijing says it was a regular meeting that focused on international affairs and not Nepal's politics.
中联部的有关团组于近日访问了尼泊尔，广泛会见尼朝野主要政党领导人，就中尼党籍交往与互学互鉴、推动“一带一路”框架内各领域务实合作等双方共同关心的议题交换意见。The
statement, however, has been termed farcical by observers across the political spectrum. They say China has been trying to take virtual control of Kathmandu. Nepalese youth, which has held several anti-China demonstrations in past, staged a protest against Beijing, urging it to not interfere in the domestic politics of the country. While some of the international commentators already believe that China has been guiding Kathmandu in many of its decisions, some have even raised the possibility of a Chinese hand in Nepal's recent crisis. and they advise if this is even partially factual, then now is the time when Nepalese, cutting across the political ideologies, must come together to drive out their real opposition.
Moving on, minorities are under assault in Pakistan. Their freedom is curtailed and rights snatched, despite international community repeatedly calling out the rising religious fundamentalism in the country. The number of crimes against minorities has risen sharply. Recently, a mob led by Islamic fanatics demolished a Hindu temple in Kark region of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province. They shouted religious slogans and said Pakistan had no place for infidels, a term used for non-Muslims. Rights activists have condemned the decision, saying Imran Khan's new Pakistan has nothing new and in fact the situation has worsened under his tenure. A radicalized Islamic mob led by local clerics demolished a Hindu temple, an act that further deepens the religious fault lines in the country. In what could be described as a planned attack, a rally was organized by Jamiat Ulema-e-Islami Fazl, a Sunni Deobandi political party in Pakistan, where speakers delivered fiery speeches, after which the charged crowd stormed the temple, set it ablaze and razed it to the ground. The video clip that has gone viral shows the anger people have been infused with by the religious hardliners who are gaining prominence in country's mainstream.
ये पाकिस्तान में हिंदू किसी तरह भी महफूज नहीं है, ना वो इबादत कर सकते हैं, ना वो मंदिर में जा सकते हैं। दिन ब दिन मंदिरों की तोड़ फोड़ और घिराव जलाओ का सिलसिला तेज़ होता जा रहा है। ख़ास तौर पर इमरान खान की हुकूमत जैसे जैसे कमज़ोर हो रही है और पाकिस्तानी फ़ौज के ख़िलाफ़ जो अवाम में नफ़रत है, ख़ास तौर पर खैबर पख्तूनख्वा के लोगों में जो नफ़रत है, वो जैसे जैसे दिन ब दिन जोर पकड़ रही है, तो ये टारगेट कर रहे हैं माइनॉरिटीज़ को। और सिंध के बाद अब ये खैबर पख्तूनख्वा में ये जो वाकया हुआ है, ये अब यानी कि पाकिस्तान के नॉर्थ से लेके साउथ तक कहीं पे भी कोई हिंदू जो है वो सेफ नहीं है।
Now protests have erupted in Pakistan where the community is demanding urgent justice. They want their temple to be restored to original shape and an expedited punishment for the perpetrators. Hindu representatives have sought intervention of the Supreme Court of Pakistan, which has now asked for a comprehensive report by January 4.
Supreme Court iska somoto le aur jo sharpasand hai उनको सिर्फ गिरफ्तार ना किया जाए बल्कि 295A और 295B और C के तहत उन पर मुकदमात कायम किए जाएं, क्योंकि मजहबी अकलियतों की कोई भी जगह को मुस्मार करना वो 295A में आता है।
Observers say that it wasn't an isolated incident of some hooliganism but a part of the systematic drive launched against the minorities in the state. Minorities were a considerable size in Pakistan's population in 1947, but have now reduced to a limited few owing to constant state-backed atrocities. Whether it is a Hindu, Christian or Sikh, everybody has become a victim of state-backed persecution of minorities. Forced conversions and marriages have become a common phenomenon in the region. Pakistan has been called out for its apathy towards minorities at various global platforms, but the authorities have not cared to address the issue. The United States has called it a country of particular concern for having engaged in systematic, ongoing, egregious violations of religious freedom. UN says that minorities are under threat in Pakistan. The successive governments in Pakistan have made tall claims of working in the welfare of minorities. But the vandalism of minority prayer sites, blatant misuse of blasphemy laws against them, and legislations being framed every day to further marginalize them reek of a completely opposite and inhumane situation for minorities. Now we take a look at some happenings in Asia in our segment called Asia What. As the new year approaches, China Media Group, China's major broadcaster, is counting down to its special year-end gala to be aired on the New Year's Eve. The four-hour-long CMG New Year's Eve gala will grace screens nationwide, revolving around some of the most influential events in China throughout the year, with themes ranging from the fight against COVID-19 to milestones reached by China in implementing the nation's space program. Apart from new innovative technologies that will help create a fresh show, the annual on-air gathering will also bring together top echelon celebrities from the Chinese mainland, the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region, the Macau Special Administrative Region, and the Taiwan Region. Along with song and dance performances, there will also be magic and martial arts performance. As one of China's biggest cultural events, the celebration is wished to bring hopes for 2021. With the preparation of Yomari, a steaming hot delicacy shaped like a fig, filled with molasses and sesame seeds, Nepal's Newa community marks the start of rice harvesting session in the country from the day of the full moon of Porsche. The harvest festival, marked with fanfare by Newa community of Kathmandu Valley, get its name from Yomari, the fresh harvest rice sweetmeat prepared on the full moon of the Porsche, the ninth month according to lunar calendar. Newa community worships Annapurna, the goddess of grains, for rice harvest on this full moon day. As per various beliefs, Suchandra and Krita, a married couple, first experienced with a fresh yield of rice from their field at present-day Panoti city in ancient times. The couple then distributed new delicacy to the villagers, which was liked by all, and it was named Yomari, which in Newa language means tasty bread. In Newa community, there is a tradition of sending Yomari cakes as gifts to pregnant women, as there is the belief that it gives supreme knowledge and sound mental health to the baby in the womb. Travelers hustle back to Japan as the government decided to tighten its borders, banning non-resident foreign nationals from entering the country. Japan on 26 December said it would temporarily ban non-resident foreign nationals from entering as it tightened its borders following the detection of a new highly infectious variant of the coronavirus. The latest ban took effect on Monday and will run through January. Under the new restrictions, Japanese citizens and foreign residents will be allowed to enter but must show proof of a negative coronavirus test 72 hours before departing for Japan and must quarantine for 2 weeks after arrival. Foreign diplomats have highly commented on China's efforts in COVID-19 vaccine development while visiting the production base of China National Pharmaceutical Group Corp, Sinopharm, one of the makers of China's leading vaccine candidates. A group of foreign diplomats paid the visit to Sinopharm's production base, which sent a positive signal to stronger cooperation in the global fight against the pandemic. At least 10 countries with some 60,000 volunteers have been taking part in the late-stage clinical trials for the Sinopharm jab since late June. China authorized emergency use of Sinopharm's coronavirus vaccine in June. Key groups of people, like those with higher risk of infection, are being vaccinated across the country in the current winter season and the next spring. The company has filed for its COVID-19 jab to get approval for an official rollout across China. The variation of the virus does not impact the efficacy of the Sinopharm vaccine. So far, about 60 countries are reported to have requested supplies of Sinopharm's COVID-19 vaccine. The illegally occupied region of POK is grappling with inflation. The cost of almost all items has soared. The wheat flour price has specially skyrocketed, with people not being able to purchase enough flour even for a square meal a day. People are struggling to fulfill their basic needs with the income they earn through their menial jobs. Locals say with the coming of Imran Khan's PTI in the region, their life has only changed for worse. A report. Thousands of residents in Tararkhel region of Pakistan-occupied Kashmir took to streets against an unprecedented surge in food inflation, especially the prices of wheat flour that have skyrocketed in the past few months. They termed it double whammy amid the pandemic that has already hit the economy and the employment. They also accused Islamabad of being discriminatory towards them, as the people of the region are being charged up to 60% more than what people in Pakistan pay. They urge the government to open borders with India, where they say the quality of flour is good and rates reasonable.
पाकिस्तान के अंदर दिल्ली के अंदर 1650 रुपए पे मिलता है और वही आटे का थैला यहाँ 2100-2200 और जगहों पर 2500 और 2700 का बिकता है। और हम ये कहते हैं कि अगर आप हमें ये आटा पुराने रेट पे प्रोवाइड नहीं कर सकते तो फिर हमारी बॉर्डर खोल दीजिए, हम इंडिया से आटा खरीदेंगे। तो 50% डिस्काउंट पे हमें वो आटा मियासर होगा, तमाम चीजें ये इंडिया से लेते हैं और उससे के ऊपर डबल कीमत लगा के ये हमें विरोध करते हैं।
People in the illegally occupied POK and Gilgit-Baltistan are repeatedly subjected to discriminations, where they are made to pay a significantly more amount for almost all goods and services, despite a consistently plummeting per capita income. Locals say a consistent hike in the prices has deeply affected their lifestyle, with poverty staring at a large section of the population.
आटा मियासर नहीं, आटे का किसी को नवाला तक मियासर नहीं, दो वक्त की रोटी खाने वाला एक वक्त पे आ गया है।
The administration, however, has not shown any empathy with the plight of the people. It has, in fact, cracked down on those leading the anti-government demonstrations. But the locals say that they are not fazed by this brutality and will continue to protest against the immoral pricing of even staple food. India boasts of various kinds of classical and folk dance forms. Dance revitalizes the mind and soul, and watching a performance in the backdrop of artistically carved and magnificently lit temples and monuments is a surreal experience. So, today we take you to the International Odissi Dance Festival, which mesmerized the audiences. Have a look.
Donned in traditional outfits, classical dancers from around the country participated in a 5-day-long International Odissi Dance Festival to showcase their talent. The festival promoted the rich culture of India's Odisha state. Each year, this international festival is organized by the government of Odisha with the help of Guru Kelu Charan Mohapatra Odissi Research Center in Bhubaneswar. Dancers from Indian states like Gujarat, Bangalore, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra took part and left the audience awestruck with their performance. Due to ongoing COVID-19 pandemic, international artists were not able to make it to the festival this year.
really feeling proud, and also I'm quite delighted that I was able to perform in an international festival at this age.
The festival gives an opportunity to local artists to showcase their talent and show their expertise in the field of art, music, dance and theater. It helps dancers to get trained under different gurus from different parts of the globe, besides getting to interact, improvise and learn from each other. But this year, Odissi dancers were practicing virtually to prevent the spread of the coronavirus.
This International Odissi Dance Festival is the annual feature of Odissi Research Center. Now, more than one decade, almost 14 years, we have been doing this. And but the date is always fixed from 26th to 30th of December. And here, if you calculate all the 5 days, so you will find more than 500 artists, dancers and musicians calculating all. And they represent from all over the world, international artists. And this is the platform we give to the budding artist and to the established, the middle group and the celebrities.
The 5-day event is a confluence of Odissi art and culture aimed at celebrating the love for the age-old traditional classical dance form. Even it gave a good opportunity for budding artists.
We are actually feeling very happy because at this corona time it has been organized for us, and we are the like dancers, we are not getting any platform, and in this corona time it has actually organized, so we are very happy and lucky to perform here. And last year we used to dance at Rabindra Mandap, which was actually organized in a very large from internationally dancers also used to come, but this time only Indian dancers are coming here and performing. But we are also happy since this is organized here.
Such festival represent the rich culture and traditional heritage of Odisha and preserve it for coming generations.
Viewers, now I leave you with some glimpses of New Year celebrations from across the globe. Goodbye, take care and stay safe.